Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 5.2, Problem 6. This is Section 5.2, Problem 6. It says Bill and Sue just got engaged. They want to have $16,000 3 years from now for their wedding. How much do they have to save every week at 13% compounded weekly to reach their goal? So this is a sinking fund question, and the reason that it's a sinking fund question is you know what the end result needs to be, and you want to calculate the regular savings. So the sinking fund formula is P equals A over some big brackets that have a numerator and a denominator. In the numerator of the brackets, you have 1 plus R over M to the M times T power. There's a minus 1 after that, and an R over M in the denominator. That's what we'll fill in. So when we fill the formula in, we have P equals, the A on the top of the formula is the final amount, which is $16,000. That's the goal that you want to get to. Now underneath the $16,000, you have some brackets with a numerator and a denominator. In the numerator of the brackets, you have in parentheses 1 plus R over M. So the 1 plus R is the rate as a decimal. So the rate is 13%. So as a decimal, that's 0.13. And over M. Now the type of compounding for this is compounded weekly. So M is 52 for weekly compounding because there are 52 weeks in the year. And that is in parentheses. 1 plus 0.13 over 52 is in parentheses. It has an exponent of M times T. So again, M is 52 for the type of compounding. T is the number of years. So they want to have that money 3 years from now. That's when their wedding is going to be. So it's 52 times 3 for the M times T. T is 3 for 3 years. There's a minus 1 after the parentheses, and in the denominator of the brackets, R over M, 0.13 for the R, the rate is a decimal, and 52 for the M, the number of times compounded per year for weekly compounding. So now the formula is filled out, what we have to do is start the computation. So P equals 16,000 is on the top of the formula, and underneath that you have some brackets. In the brackets we have, in the numerator of the brackets are parentheses, 0.13 over 52. I happen to know off the top of my head is 0.0025. Again, 13 over 52 is 1/4. I remember that from playing cards. There's 13 cards in each suit, which is 1/4 of the deck. Let's say you don't happen to know that. With your calculator, you want to do 0.13 divided by 52 equals. And it should tell you that the answer to that is 0.0025. And that answer, you're going to add 1 to it because there's a 1 in front of the 0.13 over 52. So in your parentheses, you have 1.0025. The exponent on the parentheses, 52 times 3, is 156. And after the parentheses is a minus 1. Don't forget the minus 1. And in the denominator of the brackets, 0.13 over 52 again, which of course comes out to 0.0025. And like the previous type of formula, you have the same decimal in the numerator and in the denominator of your brackets. In the numerator there's a 1 in front, in the denominator there is not. So what happens next is this big exponent of 156th power. So I'm going to have P equals 16,000 over some brackets. And in the numerator of the brackets, I'm going to have some big number, I'm going to get minus 1. And there's a 0.0025 in the denominator of the brackets. And that big number I referred to is going to come from 1.0025 to the 156th power, which is a huge computation, which the calculator will do easily. So let me enter on my calculator, 1.0025, press the exponent button, put in an exponent of 156, press equals, and the calculator tells me that 1.0025 to the 156th power is 1.47626218. And again, I keep all the decimals until I'm just about done. I round it at the very end. So at this point, I have p equals 16,000 over some brackets. The brackets have 1.476262138 minus 1 in the top of the brackets, 0.0025 in the denominator of the brackets. So the next part of the problem, I'll just do the minus 1. So I'll have 16,000 in the numerator of my formula still. Now the brackets will have, in the numerator of the brackets, 0.476262138, and in the denominator of the brackets, 0.0025. And let me just catch up on the calculator. I'll do minus 1. So now if I do a division, the brackets will have one number in them. So if I divide 0.476262138 divided by 0.0025, my brackets will have one number in it, and that one number will be 190.5048554. So my formula will say P equals, and I'll have a fraction, and the top of the fraction is 16,000 rather, and in the denominator of the fraction I have some brackets with the number 190.5048554. Now to finish the problem, I do 16,000 divided by 190.5048554. Now the simplest way is just clear the screen and do 16,000 and enter that number that's on the screen right now. So you might want to just store it in memory before you clear it and just enter 16,000 divided by recall memory. It'll be a little bit easier. So. And I like to save typing it in again if I can avoid it, so I'll do that. And the answer comes out to 83.98736068. Now this answer is money, so I don't want to have all these places after the decimal. I want just two places. So after the decimal I have 0.987 and then some other stuff. Well, the 7 is big enough to make it 0.99. So my final answer will be $83.99. Every week, that's not every month, it's every week. So if they save within a little bit of round off, $84 a week in 3 years, they'll have the $16,000 they need for their wedding.